done.
Is this a show now?
Oh, yeah, should we
this is her? A show? Ashley Greene, welcome to my office here at Rolling Stone, where we do this off the cuff, which means that anytime I'm boring you to death, you can just go like this and stop me and just talk
like
about
that.
Whatever you feel like. Just go, what?
You're boring.
No, yeah, you're just so dull. And I guess because it says the Twilight Saga Eclipse, that is the movie that's currently out right now.
I actually haven't seen the movie, so I'm kind of excited to see it.
Why would you not have seen the movie? You just can't
do it. I think it's going to be so lame, that movie. No, I'm kidding. I really would just rather see it with the fans and have the reaction and do the whole thing than see it a week before and then have to see it again. I have a hard time watching myself, too.
Do you?
Yeah.
Really?
I don't like it. Staring at myself this big is...
That's right, it's all IMAX.
I have a hard enough time in the
mirror. But it's not 3D.
It's not
3D yet. Maybe that would be the next two.
Don't put it past us. Yeah,
I think it could easily happen. I think it could happen. Well, you know what I have to ask you right away is that when the fans, because there's all kinds of Twilight fans. There's the Twilighters, there's the Twihards, there's the Twi-moms. They're just all over. What's the first thing they ask you when they see you? What do they want to know?
Do you know Rob Pattinson?
Do you? Yeah. I guess you might have met casually after three movies.
I said he's actually contractually obligated to talk to me. It's a little different for me than any of the guys. So the girls, especially with my character Alice, they kind of relate to me on a best friend level. Mm-hmm. And so when they come up to me, it's more of them just very, very sweet. And they're like, oh my God, I love you. You're my best friend. And that whole thing. With the guys, they want their underwear and hair and... It's a whole different
So it's
thing.
Sounding like it's mostly girls that aren't involved with coming into
Yes, although I will say Eclipse, it's the most guy-friendly I think that any of the films have been. And it's, I mean, the whole film is basically kind of action-packed.
Guys, do you hear that? It's more friendly to you.
So when the girlfriends drag you to the movie,
this time you'll get to see that action. Yeah. Your first line in the Twilight Saga Eclipse is... I've got a party due for graduation.
It's your birthday.
Yeah.
It's your birthday.
Yeah.
I always like, hey, we should plan a party because I met you. We should plan a party because it's your birthday. We should plan a party because it's graduation.
Yeah.
I love that Alice has gotten this party girl image. She's girls gone wild.
Well, you'll do anything for basically a yellow Porsche or something, you know?
I will do anything for Bella.
Is that it?
Porsche.
I don't know. You sort of want that car.
Well, you know
that was a great scene in New Moon with the car.
I personally wanted that car.
Yeah.
Alice, I think, you know, would do anything for Bella, but me personally, I was so excited to drive the Porsche. I actually got to drive it, you know. That was me.
No.
It was. Because we were in Italy, and they don't have stunt women. They only had stunt... Like, my stunt person was a man.
He was he attractive?
Not in the wig.
And I see.
Yeah, when I talked to him, he had the wig, he had the sunglasses and the scarf and the gloves, and it was very awkward.
I would love to see that.
There's a picture. I have a picture somewhere. But he had the white makeup, and they're serious about, you know, their stunt work and what they do, and he completely dressed up. But they ended up, I think, using what I did because I ended up driving more crazy than the stuntman.
Really? Yes. Was this what you did growing up? You grew up in Florida, right?
I grew up in Florida. Yeah. I didn't drive Porsches, but I was always a tomboy and kind of a daredevil, and I did martial arts and stuff like that, and I have a brother who's a year and a half older, and so we were very competitive growing up.
But you weren't a bad girl. Your parents weren't saying, oh, God, we have to watch her.
No, I learned
Maybe
from
the
my
asylum.
Brother's mistakes.
See, you saw what
kid.
Happened to him.
Yeah. No, I was a good kid, and that's why they kind of let me move out. I moved out to L.A. when I was 17. I mean, I was working in a restaurant before, so I had absolutely no idea about any of this stuff, and then all of a sudden, bam.
Were you waiting tables or hostessing?
I was hostessing.
Oh,
I don't think I was old enough to wait tables yet.
But you were modeling. And then you chose this idea that you were acting, right?
Well, my mother put me into modeling and etiquette classes to kind of build confidence and poise and stuff like that because I wasn't really a confident child. And so through that, I ended up taking...
What would you do? Were you just like shy, reluctant?
I
want to get to this twisted part of you that I know is there.
The tortured part.
Actually, it had to have been.
No, I was just friends... with older girls, like even though it was only 2 years, between 10 and 12 and 12 and 14, it's a big difference. I was looking at these older people who were more mature and they were beautiful. And so I just really wasn't that confident. So she put me into these classes and They were like, yeah, you're really not tall enough to be a model, so maybe you should take commercial classes. And I took one, and I really, really liked it, and so I took an acting class, and after the first class, I was kind of like, okay, That's it. That's what I want to do. And so my poor parents were, you know, the whole time I was like, I want to be a lawyer, and I want to get a degree in psychology.
And they were so happy.
Oh, yeah. College was prepaid. They were like, this is the golden child. And then the golden child was like, oh, no, I want to be an actor. I want to move out to Hollywood. And they were just like, are you sure?
Where do we go wrong? Do?
Thank God they were supportive.
Now, that was the question. You auditioned for Bella. As well.
Yes.
So what did you do when you were auditioning for Bella? How did you do the whole broody thing?
Apparently I didn't do it very well. I can't really teach you on that one because I didn't get the part. So yeah. I am well versed on being perky and sassy and telling the future, but apparently brooding, I didn't pass the test.
Is that you though? Are you in life this perky person who sees the good in life? Or are you just faking me out here today?
I'm such a good actor.
Yeah, I could just...
No, you know what? I try to. I certainly... Alice is kind of... It's a high standard to live up to, I think. But no, I certainly try and see things with the glass half full. And you have to. I mean, otherwise you're just miserable. And how fun is that? I'm going through this kind of incredible whirlwind. And it's fun. I'm enjoying it.
They're waving and saying you have to go to 50 more things, and so I'm coming to the yes. Well, you have to do this, but of course I need to see you do the look, the Alice look for me, when you are seeing the future, because it's like it's my favorite thing. I tried to do it, but I only look like incredibly stupid, like I've just like phased out of something. But Alice is yet focused and vague.
Oh man!
I'm Bill Condon now, and I'm saying to you, Ashley Greene.
You're going to make me do that right now?
I'm going to.
I think...
To it. Wait till I ask
maybe,
you to play
maybe
the drums.
You should go see Eclipse and then...
No, that doesn't work in here. This is the place where everybody does a scene study class.
God dang it.
And it's just a...
Really? Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Try this right now. Hold on, wait. I have to...
Yeah.
You're awful. Okay.
I am.
1, 2, 3, go.
Oh, God, I'm totally freaked.
Good?
I'm totally freaked. Okay, and the last thing is we do some kind of song that matters to you. You can sing a little bit of it.
Okay.
Maybe it's a song. What goes in your head when you're playing, Alice?
No, wait, are you going to sing? Do you know Jason Mraz?
I do.
Do it.
No, I'm not the one that sings. You do.
It has to be a collaboration.
I'll do a little drum thing if you just sing a little bit.
What song?
I don't know. Jason Mraz is anything you want.
You're ruining my life right now.
I am.
I'm just telling you.
It's my joy.
You're going to ruin it. I told everyone I could sing, and now you're just going to ruin it.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Play your drums. You ready?
Mm-hmm. I am.
Play it. Mm-hmm. You're going to play it. I'm going to sing.
I'm ready.
Go.
I have to hear what you're doing. Okay. There we go.
Well, you done me, and you know I felt it. Tried to be cool. You're so hot that I'm melted. Fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to...
No.
You're ruining my life.
No.
That's it. Just, that's all you get.
That's all I get.
Gazing into
but you know what?
And you just...
I felt it. I did. I felt
so
it.
Hot,
I felt
it
in the present, the past, and the future. Ashley, because...
That was all I was hoping to achieve.
That's what I'm feeling. And this is what we do here.
I like
it's
this.
Massive
I'm
humiliation.
Back.
Woody Harrelson did the whole song.
Well,
but it wasn't Jason Mraz,
okay,
and it wasn't...
We can't all be Woody Harrelson, so...
No, we don't want to
I
be.
Bet if you had,
we're happy
I bet
with
if
ourselves.
If you had Rob Penson, he'd make his own song.
Yeah.
I'm not bitter or anything.